Hey Beans, what is up? How you guys doing? I hope you're doing well. And today we are here with a new project from SZA called SOS. I'm really excited to get in and hear this project. I love Control. I listened to it only in like 2020, so yes, I was late to that album, but I absolutely love it. And I hadn't listened to it for a while, and I put it back on a few days ago because I knew this album was coming out, and I just like remembered how good it was. It's one of those albums, first of all, that feels like one big long piece of art because there's so many really great transitions and the album flows so well, and it just feels like this safe space in your mind. It's gorgeous. Specific things that I was like recognizing, like the percussion on Supermodel is incredible. My favorite tracks are probably Prom, 20 something. I've had Drew Barrymore stuck in my head for the past like 3 days. It's just such a good album, so I'm really excited to see where this project takes us. I can feel myself getting sick, so please excuse me if I seem a little out of it. My throat is starting to hurt, and it's really not pleasant, but I got my tea. I'm ready to just like sit and be cozy with this album. Looking at the track list though, I don't know any songs on here. I think I listened to Good Days when it came out, but I, honest to God, have not listened to it since then and I don't remember it. So I don't know any of the songs on here. And the song that I'm most excited to hear, if you know me at all, you know what I'm gonna say, Ghost in the Machine featuring Phoebe Bridgers. I had no idea she was gonna be on this project. I'm definitely excited to hear that one. First track on the album is the title track for the album, SOS. It's actually a shorter track. I mean, most of these tracks are on the shorter side, but this is one of the shortest on the album, just under 2 minutes. So, here we go. Oh, atmosphere. Ooh. Are you kidding? Atmosphere already. Oh.
Give me a second, give me a minute. Nah, little bitch, can't let you finish. Coming back, I'm so greasy. Ass nigga ain't so needy. Punk ass,
wait, place. Her voice sounds different to me. Like, still incredible, but it sounds like she's doing something different with her voice. The way it already starts out with atmosphere, like, you hear the bird. I'm guessing that is in relation to the album cover because it's like on the ocean. It kind of sounds like you're by the water at the beginning. Hi, it's me, the editor. So I just wanted to come in and say quick, I don't usually do this, but I just felt like I needed to here. I did miss that Morse code at the beginning. I pick up on it later, but I didn't realize it here. And also, I just now am realizing that like blast off kind of sound is probably a flare. And she's like all like SOS stuff and like the birds, because like, you know, you think the ocean and the cover and everything. But yeah, I just felt like I need to say that because that's so cool and I'm obsessed with it. And I hope you enjoy the video.
Free talking, I'm off the bench like Brady. I'm pressing niggas like Katie, it's up.
Brady and Katie.
Damn right, I'm the one. Damn right, I'm the one.
Ooh.
All the phony shit aside, I just
gotta feel this.
Mine.
Oh, Pulp. Shut up. No, you don't. Give me that again.
Mine.
Oh, and the echo. I don't know what like that click and then that tone. I don't know what that is or what that means, but I love it. Cause I just love that there's just unique elements coming in already on the first track. Ooh, this feels like a really good intro and it feels like it's setting up the theme for the album. Cause starting off, like, you don't by accident obviously start off your album with Last Night I Cried. Like, that's setting up the scene for, I believe, a sadder project. And I mean, with a title like SOS as the full album, you expect some sadder themes. I would think, I don't know. But I already love this. As always, the uncut version of this album reaction will be over on Patreon if you guys want to check it out. Over there, I have all my uncut album reactions. I've got exclusives. I've got these shout outs down here. Send you guys postcards. There's a bunch of stuff over there if you want to check it out. Or you just want to help support the channel, it's linked down below. And thank you so much to everyone who has gone over there already. Without you guys, I wouldn't be able to do this every day. So thank you so, so much. And let's keep going. Next is Kill Bill. I think this is one of the more popular songs because it's one of the ones I keep seeing people post on their Instagram story. Everybody's talking about this album. Creepy.
I'm still a fan even though it's salty. Hate to see you with some other, but know you happy.
No, wait, the writing on this already. Rather be in jail than alone. I love this. And it starts off creepy too, like that intro part sounded kind of like a horror movie. That's what I was gonna say, is it sounded like a horror sound. And you go in and say, I might kill my ex. I still love him though. Oh! Love that. It is a crime of passion, but damn, you was out of reach. You was at the farmer's market with your perfect peach. I'm so much sure. I'm so much sure. Oh, I'm so vocal effect. I just killed my ex. I still wait, she went to I just killed him? Be in hell than alone. She goes from I might just kill my ex to I just killed my ex. Rather be in hell than alone. But what I love about this is like the idea of like I just killed my ex or I might kill my ex. I still love him though. That overwhelming sadness that comes from losing a person that you love. There's anger and sadness and they exist next to each other in the most powerful of ways. I adore this one. It's got like a bit of a catchy melody specifically in the pre-chorus when, you know, when she's saying I'm so mature. I got me a therapist to tell me there's other men. I knew this could be a good album. We're only on track two, but trust me, the rest of it's gonna be great. I already know that. Next track is called Seek and Destroy. Like skip. You push me past my own capacity, boy. Think and destroy all missiles deployed. Drain. Now that I've ruined everything, I cannot complain. Now that I've ruined everything, now that I've ruined so everything, I had to do it to you. Do it to
love that part. Love that part.
No control. Do it to you. Do it to you.
I'm looking out for transitions too. Don't worry. Oh, that's a fun transition right there. What this song is reminding me, something that I already knew from Control. SZA is one of those artists who truly, yes, the voice is an instrument, but she's one of the artists where it's like next level, her voice is an instrument. It's not just, it's not like she's just sitting there and singing the words to her songs. She changes the way that she is delivering what she is saying based on what she is saying. A lot of artists don't necessarily do that. They just kind of have their voice and they sing the song and they deliver the message. She uses her voice to deliver the message. Does that make sense? I also love in the outro, all the pain I know is used to fuel my soul, no control. I do it to you, no control. Throwback. I don't think that's an accidental like use of just like the word control. I feel like that is kind of referencing that era of her life or like that point in her life, that album, you know? So like I love filming these videos for you guys and everything, but I already am looking forward to just listening to this album front to back with no interruption because the way the tracks are flowing together and everything. Also, I was listening to Control in the car the other day when I had to take a trip to the post office and it was just like such a beautiful driving album and I feel like this could be too and I'm already excited to listen to it in the car. Next is Low. I'm on the loop, I'm out of range. So many layers happening right now. But these bitches in my business call me out to choosing violence. If you see me out in public, you don't know me, keep it silent. We can't be outside cause the black is too high. Ooh, I love that right there. Wherever you are, whatever you need, don't call me.
But you trying to make me look stupid. I slapped the dog shit after stop playing with you.
I forgot. Voice memos is another thing that you can expect from SZA based on Control. Oh my god, the voice memo on the end of Garden is my favorite one on that album, although also at the end of 20 something. This one I didn't connect with as much on first listen, but maybe in the future I will. Next we're getting into a song called Love Language. It's funny, I was just talking about the like five love languages the other day on a live stream actually. Oh, I already like this production wise. Patience ain't no virtue with you. I'd waste plenty of time pacing around, hate this cool. You with bitches on the side and let my mind wander too. You relentless, oh, nigga. The vocals on this. I don't need brand new to talk to me. In your love language. Show me, yeah. I wanna connect to you. Your love language. I love this one. Ooh. Program, section like a slow gym. Stick around cause I want to. Bad as I wanna keep focused. Please don't deny me.
Ow. Ooh. Oh, I love this outro. Makes me want to, like, take a nap on a cloud. Oh, and then you get... No, not the transition. That is a beautiful transition. It sounds like you hear the waves, and then it feels like the SOS Morse code. If it's not SOS, it sounds like Morse code. That song was gorgeous from the production, instrumental, to the vocals, to the lyrics. It feels like it's about like losing somebody again that you love and like wanting them to show you what they need so that you can be that for them, which is a sad concept in and of itself. Need you to talk to me in your love language. Help me understand how you speak your love language. I really love this. I'm obsessed with the outro too. The instrumental outro and then that transition into the next song, which is Blind. Oh, that was gorgeous. That's one of my favorites. I'm hearting it as one of my favorites. Next song is Blind. I'm gonna let that transition play through again though, cause yes please. Waves. Morse code. Are you kidding me?
Way past it. Way.
Ooh, no.
Fucking on my ex cause he validate me. Fucking up a check, I don't want no receipt. Mind get possessed, let my spirit speak freely. Hey.
Wait, no, hold on. I need to pause because like I want to process what is happening. I feel like I'm floating away. Her lighter vocals over this really light production is beautiful. With the ocean at the beginning, no.
Why my how the times change? I'm still playing the victim and you still playing the pick me. It's so embarrassing, I can't see, I'm blind.
Oh, this is so cool too.
I don't want righteousness, I hurt too much, I lost too much, I lost too much, I hit my clutch and room, third day pop out the tomb. I like when you put your gun at the red light. I like all that violence, give me dysfunction. It's so embarrassing.
Wow.
All of the things I need living inside of me. I can't see, I'm blind.
Give me this again. It's the way all of that is layered over that production. In general, am I a fan of like voice modification stuff? No, but where it fits, and it fits there because like it's her voice on some of them, and then it's just like super modified on others, but the way it's like layered and blended and over that production, oh, it's so pretty. And again, sad, jeez. Might get possessed, let my spirit speak freely. I love that line. It's so embarrassing, all the things I need living inside of me. I can't see it. It's so embarrassing, all the love I seek living inside of me. I can't see, I'm blind. I like all that violence, give me dysfunction. I like when you come, never stay the whole night. It sounds like this idea of like going back to a toxic relationship and only feeling comfortable when a relationship is toxic and negative like that. And like, I know a lot of people experience that where like every time something's good and right and actually positive and healthy, like you push it away for that dysfunction, for that violence, that just that negative toxic energy, you know, like that's just sometimes the cycle that people get stuck in. Especially if, now I don't know if that's the case here, but especially if you like you can't find love, which like she says, love within me, I can't see, I'm blind. So the idea like that you can't love yourself, so you can't accept love properly from another person. I don't know, it's just really pretty. I love it. Production, lyrics, vocals, the post-chorus, I'm obsessed with the post-chorus. This one's one of my favorites. Okay, next we are listening to a song called Used, featuring Don Toliver, who I don't believe I know. I apologize.
Yeah, push away
inside of me. I barely understood that, but I see.
Used to being used like this. Ain't no difference, I'm molded like.
Oh no.
My gear chip sharing my vision. Might as well keep up. If it's even
worth it, well.
Moments stolen taste better.
Ooh, moments stolen. Ooh, I love that. Moments stolen taste better. Stolen moments. Beautiful stolen moments. Moments stolen taste better. Oh, I really like that. Not her starting out though with guess I've been used to being used like this. Oh, SZA, no.
I've been riding through this cold world. Thought you had another one and caught a widow girl.
Let them stress me too much. Can't
death stress me too much.
What we done living daylight. Can't trust nobody.
I've been riding through this cold world.
I like his part a lot too.
Something calling to get closer.
Oh, I was expecting it to go down after that, like kind of like fade out. It up a notch. I like this one. This one has a really calm just kind of vibe to it. I'm already picturing driving to this one because like it snowed yesterday, so everything's covered in snow. So like I kind of just want to jump in my car real quick right now and go for a drive and listen to this. And again, it's just flowing so nicely track to track, and it's something that I won't be able to appreciate as much until I listen to it start to finish, no pausing, no chatting between tracks. No, I'm still not over the transition between Love Language and Blind. That was so good. Next we have a song called Snooze. How many times did I hit snooze this morning? Too many. Okay, everybody settle in.
Tell the truth, I look better under you. I can't lose when I'm with you. How can I snooze and miss the moment? You just too important. I can't
This chorus is so cute. It's so pretty. I can't lose when I'm with you. How can I snooze and miss the moment? You're just too important. Dude, I love this chorus. And then you do that. Stop.
Nasty habits take a hold when you're not here. Ain't a home when you're not here. Are they growing when you're not here? I'm saying.
Ooh, this feels like the first happy song on the album. Out on me. Hold on. Is this a happy song or a sad song? I think it's a sad song again. I thought it was gonna be a happy one about like being in love, but then the bridge happened because she's saying like, I can't lose when I'm with you. How can I snooze and miss the moment? Being here in the moment with you is all that matters. You're too important. But then in the bridge, how you fronting on me and I'm the main one trying. How you blame it on me and you the main one lying. How you threatening to leave and I'm the main one crying. I'm the one who loves you and you're just treating me like garbage. Is that where we're at? Just trying to be your everything? This song is so pretty. Oh, I really thought it was a happy love song, but you know what? I've been wrong many a time in my YouTube career. Next, we have a song, Notice Me. Ooh. Got a lot going on.
I don't wanna be your girlfriend. I'm just trying to be your person. I don't need to be your girl. Wonder if you notice me.
So I don't want to be your girlfriend, I just want to be your person. Does that mean, it sounds like you tried to be romantic with this person, it didn't work out, but you still care about them, and you just want to be the person that they go to, regardless? Or am I completely misunderstanding that? Either way, I like the chorus a lot.
If they lost your mind, I understand, man. Sit on this and blow.
Hello.
Cool, but just be, yeah, your person.
Yeah, already tried to be your girl. Doesn't deserve you. That's where we're at. Oh. Oh my God. Wait. No, not that. It's the same transition. It's the same transition with the ocean and the birds and the Morse code. Whatever that next song is, sounds like it's gonna be beautiful, but oh my God, wait. It sounds like she does still care about this person, but at the same time, they don't deserve her. They didn't treat her right, so she still wants to be there for them, but not in a relationship-esque kind of way. This next song, whatever this song is gonna be, it started off, that transition started off gorgeous, called Gone Girl. That's like a movie or a book, right? I haven't read it slash seen it. Not that I think this is gonna be related to that in any way, but Gone Girl. Oh, I need to hear the transition again though. Ready? Oh my God, I love. Okay, this? Are you kidding? Shut up. What was it?
Split mind, don't need an assignment.
Oh, that vocal intro. I'm sorry. I keep pausing. That was... Oh! All right, I won't pause again. I'm sorry. That was just... I can't.
Shift eyes, they tell me you lying. Don't care, just lay it beside me. Ain't time chasing the rewind. Ain't time...
Chasing the rewind.
Squeezing too tight, boy. You're losing me. Boy, you're losing.
Pretty hold.
Trying to grow without hating
that this song makes you feel bad, but in a good way. Hit me like that. You're hearing the layers, the percussion, that choir. What was that? Okay, my camera stopped recording. I don't know when. All I was saying is the end. It sounds like something like breaks and falls apart. That's like the way the end, like that outro piece feels, like breaking down and falling apart. I don't know, that's like what I was picturing, like almost like a mountain crumbling. That's just what was happening in my head. When she's saying gone girl, is she talking about her past self? My favorite part, I think, is that intro piece coming from the other song within the outro. But then like the whole pre-chorus idea, like I need space and security. I need less voices, just you and me. I need your touch, not your scrutiny. Squeezing too tight, boy, you're losing me. SZA references the critically acclaimed psychological crime thriller Gone Girl on this track and channels its themes of love, relationships, and abandonment. Oh, okay, so it does have to do with like the actual book, movie, whatever. I love this one too. There's only been like one song so far that I didn't love. The rest of them have all been so good. Next we have Smoking on My X-Pack. Roll the clip and run it back. I'm really like that. I'm really not friendly. I was not ready. Infection like micro. Sorry, I didn't have the lyrics up yet, and then I just was getting distracted by trying to. I wasn't ready. Oh, this one's really short. This one's only a minute 23. Oh, so this one's kind of like an interlude, kind of like wavy, low key, maybe. I don't know. Whack your favorite athlete, scream and text me back. I make no exception. The lesser part of me loves all the cap. Your favorite athlete, scream and text me back. Them whole accusations weak. The bitch accusations true. You hating from nosebleeds. I wish you well. Smoking on my expat tonight. Ooh. Smoking on my expat tonight. And I can't trust in you. Yeah. What is being said in the background? If anybody knows, tell me. Oh, I got that one. You can trust in me. This one I feel like is really, you really gotta like read the lyrics. Cause this is, you know, lyric heavy, obviously. Very interlude-esque. My favorite lyric is your favorite athlete scream and text me back. The last section I like the best, that chorus section, spoken to my X-Pack tonight. And just like the you can trust in me, you said I can trust in you. You said I can trust in you? Makes me feel like that's what you said, but then you proved me wrong. Like, and whatever was going on in the background, I really liked too. I don't know what it was saying, but it was just kind of felt like it was zigzagging. Kind of like an airplane. It was like flying through the background. Next we have Ghosts in the Machine featuring Phoebe Bridgers. Now, if you know me, like I said before, I'm a big fan of Phoebe Bridgers. And I was so surprised when I saw that she was on this album. I did not expect it. And I'm really excited. And it being called Ghost in the Machine feels appropriate for some reason, like as like a song that Phoebe would be a part of. I don't know, I associate Ghost with Phoebe because of Stranger in the Alps. The Machine kind of reminds me of the end. I don't know. Anyway, here we go. I like the production on this. It feels very Phoebe, actually. You're like humanity, drowning in vanity, craving humanity. I need humanity. Let's talk about AI. Robot got more heart than mine. Robot got future, I don't. Robot can't sleep, but I don't power down. Ah, robot. No more wind, wide open. Can you distract me from all the disaster? First of all, I just like love the flow of this song, but I love that section, specifically the line, robot could sleep, but I don't power down. Cause like you're switching like the concept of you sleep, robots power down, but the robot can sleep, I can't power down. I don't know why that like jumped out at me. I really like that. Can you hate on me and mask it with laughter? Hate on me and mask it with laughter. Can you lead me to the honeys? All my friends are on my payroll. You're not wrong, you're an asshole. Screaming at you. What, the layering? I was yours for free. Oh, yes, right there. Standing on my own in an airport bar, a hotel lobby. Ooh, wait, I have things. Ooh! Okay, Phoebe. Wait, before we keep going, I just want to say, it sounds like there's like this crackling in the background under that, which is really cool. I don't know what it means or like why it's there, but it sounds really cool. I guess we'll talk more at the end. Sorry, I just... Oh, I really like... Okay, sorry. I need humanity.
Oh! Those who have forsaken their humanity, they are trying to patch their life with morality.
I think I might be trying to patch my life with morality.
Oh, wow. Oh, shut up. That was even better than I thought. It was even better than I imagined it would be. Wow. First of all, it feels like the song as a whole is just kind of about feeling disconnected from life and feeling non-human, so to speak, just like feeling like maybe bigger than life. I don't know if it has to do with living in a world of fame and that like taking away some of your humanity, but like she directly references like robots and AI and the song being called Ghost in the Machine. So I guess she's like saying that she is the ghost in the machine because she feels like she's saying like a robot, but she does have, you know, a soul. She is human, but she's living as if she's like a robot kind of a thing, ghost in the machine. I don't know. What I love too about Phoebe's is like, specifically the lyric that stood out to me there was standing on my own in an airport bar or hotel lobby. That feels like such a Phoebe lyric. That feels like something that I would hear in a Phoebe song 100%. That kind of more specific storytelling, setting, atmosphere kind of feel. Craving humanity. I wanna come back maybe to myself, to my roots, to feeling like me again. I don't know. This song is gorgeous. The outro. He creates a distinction between morality and humanity. According to him, morality is a relative and debatable construct that can be created by individuals and societies according to their needs or interests. Clashing moralities therefore lead to conflict. Humanity, on the other hand, is derived from an awakened natural sense. Maintaining this humanity allows for humans to associate with beauty and without enforcement, shame, guilt, or fear. Oh, this song feels so deep. This song feels like I could sit here for an hour just picking this one song apart because there's so many interesting lyrics and the concept as a whole and having Phoebe on it and like Phoebe's verse is very, break that apart? No, not really. And also, I liked Phoebe's voice on this. There was a lot of like really cool layering that I feel like I'm not used to with her. This song, I love. Next song that we are getting into is F2F. I don't know if I should know what that means already, but I don't, so I apologize. Wait, did that transition? Whoa, what is that? What is that? What just happened? Sorry, hold on. I need to hear this. It doesn't, but it feels like it comes in so quick that it would. It still flows nicely. But what is this? I've been thinking about you. What is this? Wait, is it just me or is this... Wait, maybe I'm stupid, but like, this feels so different from everything else that we've heard. I already like the sound of it a lot, but like, what is this? Wait, this sounds really cool. This sounds really different. Hold on, everybody, hold on. I miss you. You know? Will you call me? Will you hang me out to dry? Oh, vocals. This chorus. Get a rise, I know watching you fall off this wire. What the hell is this? What the hell is this? I have not paid attention to the lyrics. I'm sorry, I got distracted. Oh my god, the aliens are coming. All right, I'm not gonna lie. Did not pay attention to the lyrics like at all because I was just so thrown by like the entire switch up in production. This feels like a pop rock kind of song. It just kind of came out of nowhere. This is really fun. It's just like something different. It's definitely gonna be a standout on the album, whether you like it or not. It's a standout because it's very different. This is another sad song though, because it's about missing somebody, probably who didn't treat you well. Get a rise out of watching you fall, get a kick out of missing your call. I hate me enough for the two of us. I hate me enough for the two of us. I love this. One of Sis's best friends in music, Lizzo, has writing credits on the song? Well, that's cool. Can someone tell me what F to F means? I'm so stupid. Oh wait, what does F2F stand for? It's unknown right now, but it likely means fuck to forget. Okay, that would make sense. I love this song. Next, we are going to the song Nobody Gets Me. I believe this is a single because it does have a music video, but I, for this album, just kind of wanted to like listen to it without jumping in and out for music videos. So we're just gonna listen to it, but it's called Nobody Gets Me. This sounds really different too. Just straight up, is this whole thing just straight up acoustic guitar?
Took a long vacation, no makeup, just Jay-Z. You were balls deep, now we beefing.
Whoa.
I mean, I don't wanna lose. What's left of you? How am I supposed to tell you? I don't wanna
again?
See you with anyone but me. No.
Sorry, again, I was getting distracted by like, just the difference. And I wasn't paying attention to the lyrics. What's left of you? How am I supposed to tell you? I don't want to see you with anyone but me. Nobody gets me like you. That's so sad. And it's sad, like sad sounding production. Just that acoustic guitar.
Only like myself when I'm with you. Nobody gets me, you.
No. Oh no.
You proposed, I went on the road. You was feeling empty, so you left me. Now I'm stuck dealing with a deadbeat. If I'm real, I deserve less. If I was you, I wouldn't take me back. But it's too late, I don't wanna lose. Nobody gets me, you do. You do.
I could cry. I could cry.
Nobody gets me, oh, do.
What just happened? Wow, this was so gorgeous. Again, so different. Oh, the second verse is, I mean, lyrics almost took me out, guys. They're this close. I mean, you guys know, like, acoustic music is very much my style. I love, like, very light acoustic kind of stuff. So this is right down my alley, and I love it. What's next? Conceited is next. Okay, let's get the energy back up. This album is so sad, by the way. I think I already said that, but, like, it's just so sad. Energy back up, energy back up. Come on.
I don't like nobody, I don't feel guilty about it.
That's fair.
I just got my body done and got no guilt about it.
Good.
I just heard your opinion, I couldn't do without it.
Fair.
Loud about my salary, oh.
As you should.
Heard they got me, oh.
They should've.
Love it when they got me, oh.
Love that verse.
I got everything that I need and I want more. I can't tell my
okay.
foot off and burning bridges, I do it over again.
Oh, confidence. Oh, I needed some confidence in this album. Right here.
I got no reason to depend on you. No reason to be friends.
The lyric, I got no reason to depend on you, is kind of interesting in this album because a lot of the songs in this, obviously they could be about very different things, but like a lot of the lyrics on this album so far are about like truly depending so heavily on another person. And in one of the songs, was it the last song? She said something along the lines of like, I'm my best version of myself when I'm with you. I can't be me without you. So to come to this song and have a more confident side of that idea of I got no reason to depend on you. I like that.
Me.
I'm betting on me, oh, as you should. I did not see that coming. Love, love, I'm gonna sneeze, hold on. That's one of my favorites because it's such a different feel from the other songs from like a thematic perspective of just like, I'm betting on me. And there's so much confidence of like, I don't need you. I have everything I need, I want more, okay. Heard they counting me out, love it when they count me out. Cause then I prove them wrong and then they look like fools. This one's really good. Next we're getting into a song called Special. Are you kidding me? With the acoustic guitar again.
I wish I was that girl from the Gucci store. She never wore any makeup and she owns couture. I never liked her, wanted to be like her. Hate how you look at her, cause you never saw me. Like I was an art piece, like I was an ordinary girl.
Stop, 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 stop. Oh my god, I love, oh my god. Wait, this might be the one to take me out, but let's hope not. Like I was an ordinary girl, that kind of reminds me of Normal Girl from Control. Fuck, I love this. Okay, sorry.
You made me hate
me regret that I changed me. I hate that what? You made me just like you.
Oh my god, stop!
Just like you.
Sissy!
You, why'd you have to treat me like I was ordinary?
Oh. I wish
just like you.
I gave all my special away to a loser, now I'm just a loser. Oh, what is that? Oh, the distant vocal. And it feels like we're like almost underwater right now. Oh my god, where are we going? I'm floating underwater. Am I drowning? I don't know. SZA, is she for real with that song? Is she for real? Basic Caitlyn opinion that everybody expected already. This might be my favorite song on the album. Oh, the lyrics are so heart-wrenching and I love them. The lyrics, the vocal, the outro. I could scream about how much I love that outro over and over and over forever and ever and ever. It's so pretty. I mean, there's nothing else I can say. SZA, thank you for this song. I love it. God, what's next? Too late. Is it too late? I don't know. She's gonna end me with this production.
Ooh. I don't be alone to figure out how I should be loved.
Ooh, yes!
Can't get enough. Is it bad that I want more?
I love the melody on Is It Bad That I Want More?
Pressure, I won't learn my lesson. I want you to stretch it. Limit, won't you to test it? I know.
Wait, this sounds toxic.
I can't get enough. Is it bad and I want more? Is it too late for us?
Are you good?
How do I deal with rejection?
Every time the ocean comes in, I die because then we transition so beautifully. Sorry. Is it bad that I want more? It might be. So done with you. Nobody got me like you do. Every time you break my heart, it feel new, but we don't want people to break our hearts, right? God, everything is so fucking sad on this album. Not everything. Conceited was a good switch up for us, but so much of it is so sad. I done go alone and get it how I want it. Had to be alone to figure out how I should be loved. And if it's just us, is that enough? Is it bad that I want more? So like, I guess revisiting this relationship again with a new perspective of like she says, I was alone. I now know the kind of love I deserve. We could try again and see if you can give me that love and see if it works. Is it too late? I don't know. Is it bad that I want more? Maybe, but we could try again. Next is Far, right. It transitioned into this and it sounded like we were starting out with like a voice memo, which I'm all about. It goes right in. Oh my God.
How do I deal with rejection?
How
I'm dealing with a lot of rejection right now.
Aww.
That makes me feel very small.
Well, that's great. If nobody wants you, you're free.
Woo.
Better wash all of my shit away. Yep. Better wash all my emotions in a few brews. Need a palm tree. I be drinking in private. Don't call me to party though. Done being used. Done playing stupid. Done faking cool. I don't want none of the shit I want. Far, cause I can't trust nobody. Far, stay far, so far. Always on my mind. Trust is hard to find. Everything reminds me of us. I just want my sanity back.
I don't want none of that shit. Got me running short.
This song feels like it has two conflicting ideas. Like she's trying to move on, but she's still stuck a little.
Stay far, so far.
Oh, give me a nice outro. So there's a few things I'm noticing right now. One, this song feels like a fresh start. It feels like trying to start over, put all of that behind you, get far away, not only from that situation, but from the person who you were in that situation. Like she says, far, like I don't recognize me, because I let you define me. I let you change who I was. And now I want to get far away from that and start over, essentially. That's the way this song feels, and I really like that. And oh yeah, coming back to the intro, how do I deal with rejection? If nobody wants you, you're free. Coming back to that intro again after hearing the song makes it even more interesting. To me, this feels like a really good like final track to an album like this. It's not, because we still have five songs, but looking at these five songs, I know that Shirt, I Hate You, and Good Days are all songs that already came out. So I don't know if like initially this was like maybe the first 18 songs were the standard edition and then these five tracks are kind of like a deluxe edition, but instead of making it that way, they just put it all on one. And I'm only saying that because I know that three of these songs already came out, because Far feels like such a great closing track to this album. But we'll see, maybe Forgiveless later on, the actual last track, will prove itself to be a better outro. Next, we're moving into the song Shirt. I know this one came out a while ago, October 28th, 2022. Oh! First previewed as a snippet on SZA's Instagram story on October 7th, 2020. Gained traction on TikTok in early 2021. So it's an old song, but it hasn't fully been released until recently. Gotcha. We're into the darker production again. Ooh, heavier, darker production again.
Dusting on my shirt, new bitch on my nerves. Old nigga got curved, going back on my word. I'm doing this sunshine, I found a way to fuck it up.
Oh, I love that when you pulled that production out.
In the dark right now, feeling lost, but I like it.
Okay, that one's not my favorite one. The moments where the production is pulled and it's like very focused on her vocal, I really liked a lot. And I like the lyrics in that pre-chorus, in the dark right now, feeling lost, but I like it. Comfort in my sins and all about me. All I got right now. Feel a taste of resentment simmer in my skin. It's all about, and then you jump into the chorus. The next song we're getting into is Open Arms, and this is featuring Travis Scott, who is on Control as well.
When you do your best, you can, I don't tell you. When you do your best, hell, that's all you can do. You, me, and anybody else. So they always will tell you.
Wait, no, is that her again? It sounds like her. SZA's grandmother? Is it her mother or grandmother that's on the tracks in Control, or does it switch? Because that sounds like the same voice to me. Wait, now I gotta check. This is the same voice from the end of Garden. I don't know why, I just felt so much comfort the second I heard her voice. Why am I gonna cry? In 2019, a good 3 years before the release of this song, SZA lost her grandmother. Oh yeah, it says it right here. Norma's advice can also be heard on other songs such as Love Galore and Garden, Say It Like That. We were trying to listen to a song. I got distracted. I got very emotional because I heard her voice again.
When you do your best, hell, that's all you can do. You, me, and anybody
else. Why is that gonna make me cry?
Running away from where I'm from. Never can stay with no one. Loving you almost feels like something.
Oh my gosh.
When no
I can't do this one.
Open arms. Who needs self-esteem anyway? I hate myself to make you stay. Push
vocals.
Me away.
Vocals.
You're my favorite color, now you seeing every shade of me. You say that I'm tripping, I hit back like, where you taking me? Locked in for life, on God, no replacing me. Consequences, repercussions, karma keep on changing me. Just don't
I guess I gotta go.
What?
I guess it's time to go. I gotta let you go.
Stop.
I gotta let you go. I must.
Why?
Only one that's home.
I'm not crying. Oh my God.
Only one that's holding me down.
Excuse me? Oh my God, easily one of my favorites. I mean, starting out with like the voice memo from her grandmother, that was enough to take me out. And then just the sound and the lyrics, and it's sad though, because I guess like the whole outro is so, I don't know, it just hurts. It just hits in a way that doesn't feel good. I guess I gotta go. I guess it's time to go. I gotta let you go. And then she's saying like, you're the one that's holding me down. But the last line of the song, I'm the only one that's holding me down. So I gotta let you go. Open Arms is about being devoted to a person who accepts you for you and being devoted to the person who loves you. Travis sings about wanting to be in love with someone forever and wanting to be with them forever. And I see that throughout the song, but then you hit the outro and then it's, I gotta let you go. It's like, but why? Oh, this one hurts, but it's so beautiful. I love this one. It's one of my favorites. I just adore it. We'll move on to the next song, but that one just, it's gonna stick with me. Next song is I Hate You. I feel like it's gonna be a very different vibe. I know this song.
I've been down, baby. Have you ever been missing?
Ooh, the two sides to that.
Baby, I'm missing you. But
If you wonder if I hate you,
I do.
If you wonder if I hate you,
fuck you.
Oh, I love the passion that no, that's a fun song. I really like that one. But again, I already knew it. I didn't realize I already knew it. And again, okay, so Good Days is the next one. I know I've listened to this song. Do I remember anything about it? Absolutely not. I don't know why. It probably will come back to me as I'm listening to it here, though. Hold on. Atmosphere. Oh, whoa. Whoa, gorgeous. Hello? Oh, I don't recognize it.
I will be that I wasted the best in me. All your baby, you don't care. Sometimes I make a nuisance. No. Feel it a smile. Still wanna try. Still be-
My camera stopped recording at 30 minutes, but Jacob Collier, what's he doing here?
Good days, always inside. Good days in my mind.
The instrumental on this feels like a universe. This is a very... Ooh, see in the layering and the vocals.
Half of us laying waste of our youth is in the present.
Wow, half of us laying waste to our youth is in the present.
Half of us chasing fountains of youth and it's in the present now.
I like that line. Oh, yes. This is some of the most like beautiful production, I think, on this album. Oh, shut up. That was beyond gorgeous. I don't think I've heard it. I don't know how that's possible because I really thought I'd listened to this song at some point and apparently I hadn't. I didn't realize Jacob Collier was on it, who I know because of Lizzie McAlpine. This just feels like a song about hope and believing in a better future, maybe even when you're going through a dark time. Half of us laying waste to our youth, it's in the present. Half of us chasing fountains of youth and it's in the present now. Like living in the past when you should be focused on now. Thinking about like the good old days, when those good old days are now, they are in this moment here. That's a gorgeous song. I'm obsessed with the production and the overall message of this one in particular. We've made it to the final song on the album. It is called Forgiveless, featuring Old Dirty Bastard. Let's see how this album's gonna close out. Because again, this last like section of like five songs kind of feel like they would be considered deluxe tracks only because so many of them are older songs.
Hey, yo, yo, yo,
hey, 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 yo, what's up?
Baby, I can't.
I don't care about consequences, I want my lick back. You don't mind second fiddle, that's why you a bitch. You don't think for yourself and that's none of my business. You take it, okay. I did.
Alright, this one's definitely not one of my favorites, and I feel like it is another one, kind of like the interlude-esque track that's very lyric heavy because the verse is just like that one big verse that SZA has. Not one of my favorites. SZA speaks on people talking behind her back and disrespecting her. She asserts her confidence in herself, which is good because I feel like a lot of these songs are on the sadder side. I like the confident ones as well. She sets her confidence in herself and that she sees who around her is lame and won't forget, but won't be brought down by anyone either. Did I read that sentence right? Forgiveless contains two vocal samples of Old Dirty Bastard in its intro and outro respectively, as well as Hidden Place by, I've seen that name before, but I don't know how to pronounce it. So we have finished this album, which is so long, 1 hour and 8 minutes. How long does it take me to film this? My voice memo has been going for 2.5 hours, so I love it though. I'm so looking forward to listening to this album front to back, like without interruption, without sitting here, without getting up and making some tea and having a snack in the middle, just like being able to listen to it completely on its own, to see how it all flows together, because I think that's one of my favorite things about Control, the way that that album really just feels like one big long piece of art, one long song, because it all flows together so well. I don't think this album will have that same kind of feel just because there are some tracks on here that really are standout tracks because they sound so different, F2F and Nobody Gets Me, for example. But I love this project as a whole. I was like starring my favorites, but I starred, how many did I star? I starred 11 of the 23 as my favorites, so that's quite a lot. If I had to say what I think my favorites are, I mean, Open Arms, absolutely. Special, Conceited, Nobody Gets Me, F2F. Ghost in the Sheen, of course. That section of the album was probably my favorite. Gone Girl, the intro on that, I still can't get over. Snooze was so good. Blind and Love Language, those two back to back were phenomenal. Kill Bill, obviously. God, it feels like so long ago that I listened to that song. I love this album and I'm really excited to listen to it more. Really excited to spend more time with it. Really excited that we finally have another project from SZA. I know it was a long time, like 5 years between albums, which speaks to how much she cares about her work. She doesn't just drop, you know, whatever idea she has, she really wants to like make it in a way that she wants to make it, and it shows with this project, with the transitions and everything, the themes. I really love it. But thank you guys so much for hanging out with me, for listening to this project with me. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for supporting SZA. Go stream the album, go listen to the album, and support this incredible woman. So yeah, thank you guys so much for being here, and I will see you in the next one. Bye guys!